Hi, on this edition of Maizex Moving, we're going to talk about planter setup. So I'm Greg Stewart, agronomist with Maizex, and I know that many of you have been to planter clinics or thought a lot about planting technology. Many of you have probably gone over your planter already, but because it is so critical, we're going to spend a few minutes just touching on the highlights today. Stop number one, is the toolbar level when your planter is in the field and operating? So you'll need some help to do this one, right? You'll have to have the planter moving at planting speed and in the field, and someone's going to have to be out on the side making sure that this toolbar is level. If this toolbar isn't level, it's going to put a pitch on the row units to have them either nose up or nose down. We don't want that in terms of having good performance on the row unit. So toolbar level when you're in the field and operating. So the second point then that we'd want to observe when we've got the planter getting ready for the field is it carrying level left to right? Essentially that would mean checking the inflation pressure in every tire to make sure they're all at specs and they're all equal side to side so the planter carries level. You also should take an opportunity now to make sure that the bearings are good in those tires. So get them up off the ground and give them a bit of a test to make sure that bearings in those wheels that sometimes get ignored are in good shape before we head to the field. The next thing that often catches my eye when doing a walk around on a planter is how true the tailstocks that carry your closing wheels are lined up with the row unit itself. Sometimes these tailstocks or closing arm gets a bit of a twist in it, and you'll have a closing wheel that runs down into the trench. This really should be straight so that these two closing wheels are centered right over top of the trench. There's adjustment up here that you could make, but it's worth walking along before you hit the field and making sure that every tailstock and closing wheels are lined up right squarely over top of the seed trench. So now we're going to stop at the sort of the heart of the seed trench forming, your double disc opener. Really important to check that your blades are not worn too much. You know, usually you can tolerate about a half inch of wear from new to used before they need to be replaced. And so you should be checking the diameter of your blades and how much wear is on them. Follow your specs on that, but generally about a half inch is all you can tolerate before those blades should be replaced. The other key thing is that the blades should be positioned. There's washers that allow you to position the blade to make sure, in at least in the John Deere and Kinze world where the two blades come right up against each other, that they should have a pinch point here at the front that is about 2 inches, that makes sure you get a clean V at the front of that seed trench. And so a couple of business cards slid in from the top and the bottom, you know, about a 2 inch touch point here is recommended. Now if you're using heavier discs, so instead of a 3 millimeter disc, if you're using a 3.5 millimeter disc, you may not actually be able to put enough pressure on those blades to have them pinch a full 2.5 or 2 inches. You may have to live with about an inch, because if you try to flex those heavy blades too much to get a full 2 inch pinch point, the bearings aren't going to hold up. So on the heavier blades, you may be happy with just about an inch of touch here instead of the 2 inches on the lighter 3 millimeter blades. So next we focus for just a second on the seed tube itself. If you've got a seed tube that's worn or it's got a crack or a bump in it, it's really going to interfere with the seeds flowing properly down into the trench. It's going to mess up your spacing. And so clearly a key observation in terms of getting ready for the field is how in shape and smooth your seed tubes are, and that your seed tube protector is not worn too much and still giving good spacing at the bottom of the trench and good protection to the seed tube. Okay, so we're back at the back of the planter now. One of the handiest things I like having with me is just a little bit of a chain link with a couple of S hooks on it that I can raise up this tailstock out of the way so I can get a real nice look at what the trench looks like when I'm out doing the first test run in the spring. So nothing terribly fancy. Find a spot to hook it, bring this tailstock up, click it like that, just get it out of the way. So now once you've gone through with your planter, you can have a look at that trench and get a feel for how nice a job are the double disc openers doing. Is it a rough on the bottom? Is it clean to the bottom? Also, if your gauge wheels are not nice and firm up against those double disc openers, sometimes dry soil will come around on the double disc and end up in the trench. You'll be able to see that more easily if you have your tailstocks pulled up out of the way, just to give it a 50-foot run, just sort of a first check to make sure that trench is smooth, clean on the bottom. And then, of course, if you've got some seed in the planter and are running it, it's a nice option for just checking where is my seed dropping in terms of my target depth of 2 or 2.25 inches. All right, so just a few comments about closing wheels. This has been a real interesting area of research and development of try it, see what works for you. I heard a speaker the other day who made the interesting comment that the function of the row opener should be to create the trench and destroy the trench. I found that sort of an interesting phrase, which refers to the idea that obviously we've chatted about making a good seed trench. At the back end here, when you have closing wheels, the idea, do you want to destroy it? Well, maybe it's a bit of a strong word, but it's an interesting concept. What do you put on the back of your planter on the closing wheel assembly to give you more of a crumbling action so that the seed trench doesn't crack open again or doesn't have a seam in it that lets in air? And so Steve on his planter here has a fairly common approach. He's got the Dawn curve tine on one side and the standard rubber closing wheel on the other, trying to give you sort of a combination of doing some crumbling and doing some firming. I've got a few other ones in front of me here. I got a Yetter one that's fairly aggressive, probably only fit for true no-till conditions. The Furrow Cruiser, more of a crumbling action, and the Schlegel. I don't know whether you can find good evidence that there's one closing wheel that fits all conditions or is best for every operation. I think you have to sort of try a few of them. In good conditions, I'm not sure that there's a whole lot of yield advantage over a properly adjusted row unit with rubber closing wheels, but I certainly have had experiences where you get into some tacky conditions that having a bit of a crumbling closing wheel does do a nicer job of finishing off that furrow than just the straight rubber. The other thing that we talk about a fair bit is whether you're like a drag chain on the back of your row unit or not. Again, it will drag some fine soil into the seed trench where the seed trench is not closed as well as you'd like it. And the other interesting thing about the chain is I think when you have the chains on and it smooths out that area, I think you do a better job of assessing what your planting depth is. Sometimes the ridge over top of a typical row unit maybe plays into not getting as accurate a look when you're out there digging to see what your seeding depth is. It's an interesting observation on my part. When you put the chains on and it smooths it out, I think you do a more accurate job of assessing whether you're at that 2 or 2.25 or 2.5 inch planting depth. Which, of course, I would be remiss if I didn't spend a minute talking about our Maizex project, where we've been looking at, is there some yield advantage to planting deeper than 2 inches, even pushing it down to 3 inches. Over the, 30 some sites that we've done over the last 2 years, planting a bit on the deeper, maybe not necessarily having to go right to 3 inches, but being deeper than 2, pushing down into 2.5, has generally represented a bit of a yield and plant stand increase. So it's an easy, no cost thing for you to try this spring. Make sure you've got your planter set where you like it, in that 2, 2.25 inch range where you're comfortable. Make sure you're into moisture, but on a run or two, maybe it's worthwhile just knocking it down to 2.75, 3 inches even, and just observe how uniform your stand is if you went a little bit deeper. One thing we certainly have concluded with our Maizex plots is that the risk of planting on the shallow side is much greater than the risk of being on the deeper side. All right, some final comments about the seed metering unit. I haven't talked much about it in our little walk around the planter today. I generally believe, and I think the research supports, that perfect seed placement in terms of depth and trench opening and closing and coverage and getting very uniform emergence is job number one. But you wouldn't want to ignore the importance of the seed metering unit, the singulation, and obviously being able to get your target population where you want it to be. To that end, Maizex has a little document that you can find at the Maizex website called the Seed Right document. It takes most of our key hybrids, and even by seed lot, we've ran them through a planter stand and gives you good recommendations on how to improve singulation and population targets. So whether it's a finger pickup unit and you want to look at what the brush setting should be, or whether it's a Kinsey or a John Deere vacuum setting and you want to see, well, what would be the best target vacuum to run for that particular hybrid and that particular seed lot to maximize my singulation and population accuracy, that's in this little document that will help you fine-tune your seed metering. So that's my walk around on the planter. Everyone at Maizex wishes you a safe and successful corn planting 2020.